This is the SAP Developer News for August the 28th, 2025.
Hey friends, Rich Heilman here. Hope everyone is doing well. I'm now fully rested from the Latin American Code Jam Roadshow. We had a great time, and I'm really looking forward to seeing my new friends again soon. But for now, I want to take a minute and let you all know about the latest SAP BTP ABAP Environment release, 2508, which just dropped last week. Nora Klemp from ABAP Product Management has posted a blog post outlining all of the new ABAP awesomeness for all of us to explore. ABAP development tools got a few updates, including behavior definitions for CDS table entities, a debugger comparison tool for internal tables, as well as other cool stuff. CDS got a new hierarchy generation wizard, which derives potential hierarchy nodes and guides you through the creation process. Fiori got some updates as well, including multi-dimensional reporting and multi-report applications. There are many more updates around business events, integration, reuse services, and much, much more. So check out Nora's blog post today for more information. Hope everyone is doing well, and I'll see you next time, friends. Bye for now.
We wanted to just let you know about an upcoming SAP open source webinar on Gartner. Now, Gartner is SAP's open source solution for managing Kubernetes clusters at scale. And the project is now governed under the NeoNephos Foundation, which is part of the Linux Foundation Europe. Now, this is a move that really strengthens its long-term sustainability and aligns it with the EU's important project of common European interest in the cloud infrastructure and services area. That's IPCEI-CIS. The webinar is on the 24th of September, open to all, and we'll cover Gartner's features, see some recent developments, and there'll also be some live demos. The link to the webinar registration is in the description.
Hi, I'm coming to you here from my home garden, building on the segment from DJ on Gardener. By home garden, though, I seem to have a problem. I can't get Kubernetes clusters to grow. But in all seriousness, bridging between the segment on Gardener, the open source project, and home gardening, I wanted to point you to a blog post on the SAP community by Marian Weiss, sharing his home garden. Now, this isn't the normal SAP developer news segment where we talk about the latest in SAP tech trends, but it's still important because part of our efforts to reinvigorate the SAP community is bring more personality back to the community. So it's great to see Marian sharing his home garden. And we hope to do more initiatives like this and support them where we connect with one another, just not just on technical topics, but other things of interest in our lives.
Hey, everybody. Mr. Bluebeard, Josh Bentley. I am here as a community advocate to tell you we've been doing a lot of stuff in the community. So as you go through and look at the What's New section on the community, you can see updates and read about them. Jerry Janda even has put out the newsletter recently that he used to publish that actually tries to collate and make you aware of these things. So make sure you subscribe to that newsletter or check out this section on the What's New on the SAP community. To that end, I think there's several updates that have been put in place from the actual feedback board that we launched. So if you go to the feedback list and you get involved in that discussion, this is where some of the changes are coming from. So please request more things be added here, dialogue about the things that are on that list. And that's how some of these improvements come to be. And then they make it into the What's New section. A recent update that we did that's going to be a pilot until September 23rd is taking away the frames from the side of a blog post where we have a widget. And we're going to remove that widget in that side frame and give you a little less white space and more content area to read your blog post. So check that out. See if you like it better. Let us know. And in the blog post from Jerry, you can see the compare and contrast of the two pictures that show you what it looks like with it and without it. So that's one update that we want to make you aware of. Another is giving more people badges. We know you like getting badges in the SAP community. If you submit an answer or a post that gets a lot of thumbs up, those kudos, thumbs up, likes, they're going to give you badges now based on how many kudos that you get for your post. So Jerry even references, do you want to find out if you're a member of the 500 Kudo Club? Well, there's a way to check that in the instructions that he posts here in this blog post. And also, you could have a 1, a 50, 100, 200, 500 likes, depending on how many people click that they like your post. So great gamification badges that are being awarded for that. And also, we really want you to be active and give us good answers in the SAP community. And if you get a lot of accepted answers, we're going to recognize that. And so you're going to see that you are going to get retroactive likes and retroactive accepted answer badges assigned to your profile. So if you've got a lot of accepted answers and a lot of likes, you're going to get those badges assigned to your profile. So another thing, there's so much great information coming out about the community, is that we've actually gone through and we said, hey, it's hard to filter list for events and let's try to improve that. So we're adding geographic filtering and we're also adding the ability to filter a list based on SAP managed tags and a few other features that people have asked for to be able to sort the events that are happening and make sure they don't miss something that they want to attend. So check that out, as well as the final note in here, which is about dark mode. For those who want to actually switch and flip back and forth between dark mode and light mode, we are turning on dark mode to the SAP community. So if you'd like to compare and contrast that, no pun intended, but if you'd like to look at the contrasting look of dark mode, check that out. And you know what? People sometimes call me Papa Smurf, and I say that Papa Smurf had a white beard and blue skin. So I'm dark mode Papa Smurf, or maybe I'm light mode Papa Smurf. I'm not sure. Anyway, check out dark mode. Let us know what you think. There's lots of information, lots of blog posts from Jerry. I thank him so much for all the great writing he's been doing and putting out these updates. And I hope that you enjoy your SAP community. It's here for you, and we're listening. Thank you.
If you want to keep your systems clean and future ready, it's all about using the ABAP Test Cockpit, or ATC, as a governance tool to support the clean core approach. The blog post by Olga shares how ATC can help enforce clean core principles, things like catching modifications that shouldn't be there, flagging non-release APIs, and making sure your extensions are safe when it comes time to upgrade. Now you can try out the new ATC checks for clean core to reduce the number of findings in your classic ABAP development and focus your adaption efforts on real technical depth. If you're building in the ABAP cloud world and want to stay ahead of the curve, this is definitely worth a read. Check the description below for the full blog post.